So, I've been on this place called Tumblr, and I just wanted to share something. I wanted to convey some information. You see, it's not merely the case that a variety of laws now are being passed which are attempting to legalize sexual relations between people who are biologically related, so we're talking about incest, but it's been the case that throughout history, incest has been normalized and it's legal in I believe most countries, I don't know. But it's extremely commonplace, extraordinarily so. It's not some rare incident. It's a huge portion of all sexual intercourse which occurs in existence. Very unfortunately, it's very troubling. And so I came across this post which articulates my belief perfectly. Minus the first paragraph, but after that, yes, it perfectly understands that incest is a violation of consent, even if people aren't biologically related. So I guess step-incest or whatever. So I just wanted to read this because I think it conveys it for me. I could add on to it, but I think I'm just going to let the post speak for itself because what is being spoken or typed out anyway is entirely the truth, and it's very sad that people aren't critical of these social relationships, these social acts, these forms of abuse in the way that they should be, criticizing it as abuse. Seriously, the reason this keeps happening is because nobody actually puts language why incest is wrong. Everyone talks about how gross it is and how there may be genetic defects. It is a child that is conceived and those are incredibly easy to debunk. But yeah, again, I disagree with this. No, there are horrible genetic defects and this is why we need to practice negative eugenics. Anyway, the rest is completely correct. The reason incest is wrong and should be criminalized is because there is no way to have socially acceptable incest without grooming. There are inescapable power dynamics in a family unit that last forever. There are children who are vulnerable and do not have a grasp of consent. Incest is just as bad if the child isn't biological. The genetic default argument is irrelevant. In the case of siblings, they are going to be different ages. They also will have grown up together. There is no way to separate an older sibling and a younger sibling from a grooming dynamic when they live together. When you have access to a child for their entire life, you can manipulate them however you want to see inappropriate behavior as acceptable and isolate them from experiences that would counteract that. There may be rare instances where grooming doesn't happen. Step-siblings who are the same age and meet later in their development. Children who don't live together, cousins maybe. But I do not think fringe 1% of the time or less cases get to normalize the 99% that are manipulation and abuse. Even if the abuse or manipulation is unconscious, even if there is no ill intent, which is hard to imagine these days with COCSA on the rise in the average age of first porn exposure going younger and younger every year, it still messes with a child's perception of healthy relationships. When you break up with a partner, you have the ability to cut ties with them. You don't have that luxury with a family member. Abusers know this and use this as further manipulation. In even the most benign cases, it taints the entire family dynamic. And none of the best case scenarios excuse the rampant sexual abuse and grooming, which makes up nearly all of the cases. While the number of incest cases that aren't siblings, but parents, uncles, step-parents, etc. I knew incest was wrong, but never critically examined why, because it's gross and that's self-evident, isn't it? When the gay marriage debate was happening, I would hear the case that, well, incest and polygamy should be legal too then? And I didn't actually have a counter argument. It felt wrong, but didn't have words for it. Pedophilia and grooming are vile. Abuse of power is vile. And there is no way to separate that from consensual incest. Period. As stated, I really couldn't have put this better myself. There is no escape. And if you legalize sexual relations, make it legal, these sexual relations between people biologically related or living in the same house or part of a family who have been adopted or otherwise or conceived, whatever, then there's going to be so much sexual abuse. They have no way of opting out of it. The associations are entirely involuntary.